everyone. So this is the second session of the advances in post-harvest technology of fruits and vegetables, and the topic which we'll be covering today is the structure and composition of fruits and vegetables. So what are the basic categories of the fruits? There are three types of fruit categories, that is simple fruits, aggregate fruits and multiple fruits. Simple fruits, aggregates and multiple fruits, now talking about them in detail, simple fruits are produced from flowers containing just one pistil, that which contains an ovary. Example of simple fruits are apples, avocados, bananas, beans, cherries, olives, peas, tomatoes, walnuts, wheat. The date is one seeded berry, which stone is hard nutritive tissue. Aggregate fruits. Aggregate fruits are produced from flowers with multiple pistil. Examples include strawberries, raspberries and blackberries. Multiple fruits are produced from a number of flowers and include pineapples, black mulberry and figs. Fruit composition. Water is the fruit composition. The water inside a fruit is 75% to 90% on average. Water soluble substances are sugars, salts, acid, water soluble pigments and vitamins. Fat soluble substances are fats, minerals, fat soluble vitamins. Carbohydrates are 10% to 25% on average, sugars, starch and cellulose. Proteins are 6% to 2%, 0.6% to 2% on average. Fat is 0.1% to 0.55% on average, except for certain fruits, that is avocado has 15% fat. Minerals are low in fruits are low in minerals. Vitamins are ascorbic acid, such as citrus fruits, strawberries, cantaloupe. Beta carotene are yellow fruits, apricots, cantaloupe, and folic acid are citrus, kiwi, and strawberries. Classification of vegetables. Vegetables can generally be grouped into three categories, such as bulbs, roots, and tubers, and flowers, buds, stems, and leaves, and fruits, seeds, and pods. The origin of vegetables from different plant parts. The origin of vegetable affect how they are best handled after harvest. For example, vegetables from above ground are more likely to have waxy skin and protect them from water loss. Roots and tubers do not have such protection, so may require high humidity to limit dehydration. Seeds necessarily contain stored energy in the form of sugars or carbohydrates. Buds and shoots generally have few stored reserves and are developed rapidly, so need careful handling to preserve them. The contents in 100 gram of vegetables are broccoli. The carbohydrate and sugar percentage in different vegetables are: broccoli has 0.4% of carbohydrate and 0.4% of sugar. Asian leafy pak choy has 2.2 gram of carbohydrate and 1.2 gram of sugar. Eggplant has 2.4 gram of carbohydrate and 2.4 gram of sugar. Beans have 2.7 gram of carbohydrate and 1.3 gram of sugar. Carrots have 5 gram of carbohydrate and 5 gram of sugar, which is a good amount of carbohydrate and sugar. Kale has 8.8 gram of carbohydrate and 2.3 gram of sugar. Sweet potato has 12.5 gram of carbohydrate and 3.7% of sugar. And sweet corn has 14.1 gram of carbohydrate and 6.5 gram of sugar. Why is consumption of fruits and vegetables important? The consumption of fruits and vegetables is important for human health because these foods are primary source of some essential nutrients and contain phytochemicals that may lower the risk of chronic diseases. Because many fruits and vegetables available to the United States population vary in composition of both nutrients and phytochemicals, classification of fruits and vegetables is important to researchers who attempt to assess relationship among diet, health and disease. For example, researchers who develop food frequency questionnaires often need to gauge their fruits and vegetables questions to assess intake of specific food components. Other methods of classification of fruits and vegetables. Other methods of classification such as that appear to be related to the food composition includes those based on botanical families, color and edible part of plants. Another potentially important classification might be total antioxidant capacity, because the protection that fruits and vegetables offer against cancer, cardiovascular diseases and other diseases has been attributed to various antioxidants they contain. Total antioxidant capacity is thought to be reflect or to reflect concentration of ascorbic acid, alpha tocopherol, beta carotene, various flavonoids, glutathione, and mainly phenolic compounds present in foods. The goal of this work was to group fruits and vegetables into homogeneous cluster based on their food components profiles, and investigate potential classification variables for these foods that relate specifically to food composition. Such classification could help researchers develop the fruits and vegetables section of their food frequency questionnaires, teach students about food composition, and assist dietitians in providing dietary guidances to patients and clients. Previous studies suggest that mathematical clustering algorithm method can be used to overcome the challenge of dealing with multiple food components simultaneously to objectively classify foods. That's all for this session. Thank you.